Welcome to my new tutorial. I'm SV and today I will show you how to make this composition. This tutorial I divide for three different video lessons. In first lessons I will show you how to make modeling of streetlight or lamp stand. I will show you how to make a street curb, borders, how to add some building from Video Copilot Metropolitan pack, and how to set up it everything in the scene. So, if you are ready, we will start. We are in Cinema 4D and I will start from modeling of our street lights or lamp stand. You can call how to you like. So, for this I will use a loft tool, and of course I will do everything in real size, and my street light will be 5 meters high. So I will create just like reference a cube, put somewhere here, go to front view and create a standard circle. I will start from circle. I will put down and decrease size maybe 15 centimeters only. So put the circle inside in the loft. What I can do now? I increase, hold Ctrl on my keyboard and put little bit up, just few centimeters up. Then hold Ctrl and again. As you can see, I make some copy. So when copy is done, I reduce the size. Okay, I have like this. This is will be like a beginning, like a platform. So increase more. It 1 meter approximately, and little bit more. Take size for 8 centimeters. Increase more. I don't know. Maybe to this somewhere here. Approximately 4 meters, and reduce size up to 5 centimeters, like this. What I will do now, I like finally bend this moment, and for this I need additional segments. So I will do like this. I will take additional segments to make a copy of my circle. So when it's almost done, I will add rectangle tool, make my rectangle 10 centimeters for 10 centimeters and put down somewhere here. And what I need to pick up somewhere here, and what I have. Okay, change a plane of this rectangle like this. Very good. And okay, 5 centimeters will be 5 centimeters. Increase. Very nice. And increase little bit more and reduce. Here will be maybe 3 centimeters. Here will be only 5 centimeters. Like this end. So what I have? I already know. No, cube I will keep it. I have like this platform. So I will take and increase little bit radius, maybe 20 centimeters, 20 here and about 15 here, will be like this. Very nice. It's not necessary to make very good exactly composition, because finally we'll no need it. So now I will add bend tool inside here, pick up and somewhere here. Yeah, very good. And I will bend. As you can see, it's bended. Maybe I will use 80% only, and I reduce the size. Okay, maybe like this. What I have, It's very long. So I will create here. Take out it and where is my circle? Somewhere from this circle up to end, I just little bit put down, maybe like this. Okay, again, what I have? So looks like good. I like it, and I will leave like this. It's approximately 5 meters, maybe little bit more. So take out my cube, I don't need it anymore, and just do not display bent object. So I have my loft object, I will call it street light. Very nice. Okie dokes, here is my street light. What I will do now, take the street light, go to MoGraph, go to cloner, and put inside to the cloner. Settings for my cloner, not necessary, keep here, and increase like this. Between my lights I will make it 3 meters. Maybe 3 meters will be good, maybe 4 meters. Like this. Okay, I think 4 meters will be nice. And I increase up to, I don't know, maybe 25. It will be very, very, very long street, maybe like this. Okay, good. Now we are make some modeling of my street. So I will do a street curb or border. I go to standard cube. I will make it size, I don't know, maybe what size of usually street border, maybe 15 centimeters and maybe only 20 centimeters, maybe like this, or maybe more, 25 centimeter. No, 25 I think is too much, so I will use a 20 centimeter. Put somewhere here, little bit to forward, apply a fillet, maybe for 2 centimeters, just to receive some very small specular, and reduce the subdivision. I don't need the subdivision too much. So I have it, and what I have to do, put this, I call it curb. Also put inside in the cloner. And we will do almost same settings, but as my curb only 200 centimeters for cloner distance, I will use also 200 centimeters. Like this, little bit here, and increase up to maybe 50. Up to 50 will be good. Check from top. Okay, very nice. Very nice, I have something. What I will do now? Going to standard plane, and we create a road behind this border somewhere here. Just check it what we have. We will put somewhere here. Very good. Okay, it's touching. Little okay, as you can see my border not on the plane, so I pick up it maybe like this. And this I also just little bit pick up, maybe here, maybe little bit, just okie doke, like this. So take this plane and too much increase size, I don't know. We will check from the top, and we will go in. Oh, not here, here. Yeah, you see it start increasing, I don't know how many meters. I think I need little bit more, maybe it will be about 10,100 meter street. Okay, I have it, I have, very nice. And I will create just main road. So I go to plane, normal plane, put somewhere here, and my road will be 8 meters. Oh, no, 8 meters will be here. Like this. maybe it's small. I will check, I will find the position which I will use finally. Yeah, I think 8 meters, maybe we will do 9 meters. I don't know, it's just check. And also 10,000 also. Put like this. Okay, it's not necessary to make exactly position, because finally, if you like to receive very photorealistic render, I think will be enough like this. What I will do, I take a border, take my corp cloner, copy of them, and put to this area. Just increase, and somewhere here. Very good. Like this. So, I have borders from my two sides. What I will do now? What I will do now? Now I will show you how to use an object from Video Copilot. So, if you have this plugin, it's very nice. Name of this plugin. First of all, in Adobe After Effects, I create a new solid and black color, of course. And I apply to this solid element 3D. Inside in this element 3D, I already installed Metropolitan. If you haven't like this, you can install from official site or from any torrents, it's absolutely up to you. But also, if you haven't, you have to make modeling by yourself any houses, but I have it. And what is inside? Inside I have some building construction, and I like to use some building which is like an industrial. So I have like industrial, very nice building. As you can see, it looks like very, very nice. Yes, very nice modeling. Just remember the name, industrial hall. Maybe I will use also some industrial building like this. Also, you see some building, and maybe we will use industrial hall, industrial building, and I don't know, H09, like this. Okay, 3 buildings is enough. I just check here, because here I have some good pictures, here I have material I can turn, and then when I check it, H01, industrial building and industrial hall, after that, okay, push it, okay, doesn't matter, after that I going to location of this plugin. So I know that location of my plugin, somewhere here, Metropolitan's pack. Inside, you can open Metropolitan 3D format files, going inside, and all these for element 3D. I will use building alternative files. Inside I can find some Cinema 4D files. So check what we need. As you remember, H01, just take it and drop inside in your Cinema 4D. Very good. Then I will take also industrial building, also Cinema 4D file, just take and put inside. Very good. And industrial hall, Cinema 4D file, put inside. As you can see, here is also for 3D Max some file, some standard FBX file, but I will use for Cinema 4D. Okay, very nice. So my building inside in Cinema 4D. How, as you can see, I have only one building and all my previous composition is missing. It's easy to find in this area. You go to window and inside you have my object. So I will save it on the desktop. I will call it girl in the night. Very beautiful name of this. Oh, sorry, my mistake. Girl in the night. Very nice. So we are do some modeling, going inside, and for example industrial hall. industrial hall. I have this object and I have to apply Redshift material to this object because now it using standard cinema 4D object. How to do it? Just create new Redshift object like this. Open it and then open standard object. What I have inside? Inside I have color, some map from the color. I have no diffusion. I have some luminance. I have some little bit luminance. I have reflection. And what else? What else? I have some bub, normal map. I will apply it to my Redshift material. How to do it? First of all, I take texture. Go to color, push inside in this area, select, make a copy, then go to texture, general, and paste. Very nice. Texture from this area, copy to this area. And apply this texture like diffuse color. Very good. Then we are going to reflection. I found somewhere here texture. Make a copy, Ctrl C on your keyboard. Take new texture and paste. Very nice. One more texture applied. And as here is reflections, we are take from this area and put to reflection weights. Reflection weights. What else? Normal. Industrial hall normal. Copy, new texture, put inside. And use, we cannot use like a bump without additional bump map. In other way, it's not working properly. So first put inside and after that put to the bump map. Very good. And one more thing. We have also some luminance. As you can see, it's now disable, but if you switch on it, you will have some luminance, some maybe windows like this. And I also like to transfer it to my tutorial. So just copy object, take texture and put inside. How we can apply this object to luminance? It's very, very simple. Check it. We are going to material. We are taking incandescent material or self-illumination material and apply this texture inside like a illumination alpha. Like this. If you can check, now only some few pieces have illumination. All other is dark. It's very good. And what we will do now? We have to apply material blender. First will be main base color. And then second one will be layer color number one. And how we will apply it? We will apply it like a texture blend. I don't know. Now we will check if it's working or not. Looks like working. Or maybe I will use also sprite. What is doing the sprite? Just a moment, I have to find it. I think it's somewhere in the color. Color not invert, splitter. I forget the location. Okay, material, sprite. What is doing? It's taking alpha. But before to use it, first of all, I have to check how it's working. I take this Redshift material and put hold the Alt on your keyboard and put on top of Cinema 4D material. And as you can see, it's automatically applied to my building. So going and change a Redshift render IPR start, and what we have? We have some building and now it's very difficult to understand if it's illuminated or not. So I go again to Redshift, to integration and disable default light. Yeah, as you can see, my building give me some small illumination. It's very nice, very nice. Okay, we are finished with one texture for this industrial hall. It is completed. Same situation we will do for industrial building. First of all, I make a copy. Make a copy of this material because it's already only I take out sprite. I don't need it. Yeah, I make a copy of this material. Just select counter C. Go to other building, industrial building, and put inside. No, why it's not working? Okay, it's working. Yes, now I have it. Now I have it, but as you can see, I have some different materials. Yeah. First of all, this we are going to industrial, to main. What we will do? We are check again color, luminance, reflection, normal map, like here. So I take it and start play. Color. Copy, paste here. This is reflection. Take reflection, put here. Now bump. Copy normal map, put inside to the map, to the bump. Oh, I think I forget to put this bump in other one, but okay, we will check. Then go to luminance. Take it, go to this texture, put inside. Very good. We are apply all materials to Redshift. Take it, hold Alt on your keyboard, drag and drop on the normal Redshift material. Oh, sorry, normal Cinema 4D material. Very good. I have to come back to industrial hall and just check if I have. You see, I haven't this texture. I miss it. So, luminance. How to find this texture? If I already lose it, yes, I go to my computer, go to location of this plugin, Metropolitan pack, go inside, go to textures, and somewhere here should be, yes, somewhere here. Name of this industrial. Industrial, as you can see, and industrial building, industrial hall, like this. So I take it and put inside. Very good. I find it and it's very, very simple. Okay, very good. Go back to my industrial building number one. We already finished with this texture. So copy it, put somewhere here, and override this standard texture. So check what we have. We have color, we have some luminance, we have some reflection, but no any bump. No any bump. Very good. So take it, put inside in diffuse color. Take luminance, put inside in this area for self-illumination. Very good. Take reflection, put inside in the reflection. Very nice. And in this area we no need bump, just disable, no need. Very good. Take this Redshift material, as you can see, RS, it's mean Redshift. Hold Alt on your keyboard, drag and drop. We override Cinema 4D material. Copy, open, go inside in other texture. Check what we have. Color, luminance, reflection, no bump, not normal. So diffuse color, put inside in the diffuse channel. Luminance color, put inside in illumination channel. Reflection, take and put inside to reflection. Very good. Bump we no need here. Take this texture, redshift, alt on your keyboard, drag and drop like this. Again, copy, go inside, just a moment, go inside and make same with this texture. It's for what? For some, I don't know, for some lumps, doesn't matter. So take color, copy, put inside in diffuse channel, go to luminance. Yeah, we also have luminance. Copy, put inside in this channel, reflection, copy, put inside in reflection channel, bump and normal, it's not used. So take it, alt, drag and drop. Very good. We are going to function and remove unused object. Now remaining only object which we use for my building. I go to redshift, yeah, and just check what I have. Very nice, looks like very nice. So select all of them, alt G on your keyboard, and we are call it building one, doesn't matter. And we will do same situation with last age building. You see it's only very small. So we again create some material. I do not make copy, just to show you one more time how it's working. We open it, put somewhere here, open here, very nice. And what we have? Color, diffuse color, just copy and put inside in texture in general in redshift node, then apply it like a diffuse color. Then we are going to reflection, copy, take texture, put inside and apply for reflection weights. Then we take normal, copy, new texture, put inside here, apply, this is bump, yes, apply bump map, put inside to bump map, and this bump map put inside to material like overall bump input. Very good. And what we will do now, we are going to luminance, because I will have very soon night composition. I take this luminance map, I take texture, put inside luminance map, take new self-illumination material, put this inside like a alpha channel and apply to my material also, but I cannot do this without material blender. So inside in material blender, main base material will be all my construction, and second color will be my luminance, my illumination of windows or something, and texture I will apply like a blend color like this. So when it's done, just take it, alt on your keyboard, drag and drop, go to the redshift and check if it's ready or not. Yeah, very good, we have some luminance. How to check it? Go to integration of redshift settings and take out default light and render again, and I have some windows. Very good, very nice. So we are finished it. We are going back to my girl in the night composition. We are finished with first part, first video of my tutorials. In second, I will show you how to set up the scene. If you like it, please subscribe, please put like, and see you next time. Goodbye, friends.